Hello student, today we will discuss about the steps of sexual reproduction in human beings. There are four steps of sexual reproduction. The first one is called as gametogenesis. It's gamete production step. Second one is known as fertilization. It's fusion of gamete. Third is called as embryogenesis. While fourth is called as parturition. In gametogenesis, gametes are produced. While in fertilization, fusion of gamete is done. After the fusion of gamete, two-in cell is developed, which will further develop into embryo. While whenever the embryo is fully developed, then childbirth is done. So in today's class, we will discuss about gametogenesis. Gamete and genesis. Gamete is the haploid cell that produced in the reproductive organ of male and female, male reproductive organ. In male, gamete production is done in testis, and this phenomena is called as spermatogenesis. While in female, this is done in ovary and known as oogenesis. It is sperm production. Well, this is ovum production. Sperm is known as male gamete. Well, the female gamete is called as ovum. This is done in testis. Well, this is done in ovary. From one sperm mother cell, four sperms are produced. While in the case of oogenesis, only a single ovum is produced from one ovum mother cell. Spermatogenesis is a regular process in a male. It's a continuous process. While oogenesis takes place for a limited period, it starts from the age of puberty in female, which is 12 to 14 years, and stop at the time of 45 to 50 year age. Now I am going to draw the diagram of sperm and ovum. This is the structure of a sperm. The first part is called as head. This is the head region. While the small constriction is found, this is neck. After neck, a large segment is present, which is middle piece. And the last segment is known as tail. So you can see, sperm is made up of four segments. The first one head, another one is neck, then middle piece, and after that, tail. The upper part of the sperm is made up of head, in which two components are found. The first structure is called as acrosome. This is the structure formed by Golgi body and responsible for the penetration of egg membrane. The second structure in which only DNA contained is found, it's known as nucleus. It's devoid of nucleoplasm also. Around nucleus, thin cytoplasmic layer is present. Beneath the nucleus, two centrioles are found. They are arranged perpendicularly. From the centrioles, some fine protein bars arise. These are 9+2, and these are enveloped by spiral sheath of mitochondria. The steel portion is also known as exonema. It's a flagella-like structure, and with the help of exonema, sperm can do ciliary movement. A thin cytoplasmic layer is found only in the sperm. That's why it's quite lighter in weight, so it's easy to move. This reduction in the weight is helpful in the movement of sperm. And during the movement, energy is required, which is given by mitochondrial sheath found in the middle piece. Now, the structure of ovum. Ovum is rather simpler than sperm. This is the part that carries maximum cytoplasm and the stored food also. And it's also surrounded by various membranes. Female gamete or ovum is immotile in nature because it's quite heavier structure. Immotile means immovable. Now the next one is about ovarian cycle or menstrual cycle. This is also known as ovarian cycle. Or I can say in this cycle two steps are done, ovarian cycle and uterine cycle. It's a cyclic phase of flow of blood with mucus and tissue, etc. from the uterus of a woman at the month interval, and interval of 28 days. It starts in the age of puberty. As I told you earlier, it starts in female at the age of puberty, and that is 12 to 14 year age. This is known as menarche. While it stops in the age of 45 to 50 year age, which is also known as menopause. In the gap between menarche and menopause, this is the female reproductive age. After menopause, ovum production stops. That's why the female is not able to produce any offspring. It's a cyclic phase in which four events are running. The first is known as proliferation phase. This is the phase where the germinal epithelium of ovary will divide and form various oocytes. And at the last, this oocyte get converted into, by meiosis process, this will form ovum. So by this cycle, only one ovum is produced inside the ovary. The second step is known as ovulation or ovulatory phase. This is the phase where ovulation is done. Now the point is, what is ovulation? It's release of ovum from the ovary into coelom. This is usually done from the 13th to 15th day of this cycle. After ovulation, a lesion is formed inside the ovary. This is known as, this lesion is converted into the glandular system, and they will release progesterone, and the structure is called as corpus luteum. That's why this phase is known as luteal phase. Because of the formation of corpus luteum that secretes progesterone. Now, if fertilization is done, then this stage is prolonged up to the gestation period. Otherwise, so whatever changes are done in ovary and uterus to conceive the embryo, or for the development of embryo in uterus, All these are waste now, so they have to remove out of the body. The last phase is known as menstrual phase. Removal of cells of endometrial wall, egg cell, mucus, and a little bit amount of blood. This is done for 3 to 5 days. While luteal phase is prolonged up to from the 15th to 28th day of the cycle, while we have seen the ovulatory phase is running in between 13 to 15 days, while from 5th to 13th day, proliferation phase is. So I can draw a line diagram for this, which is like this. This is the fourth cycle, menstrual phase. While this period is indicating to proliferation phase, the next one is indicating to ovulation phase, ovulatory phase, and the last one is indicating to the gap between 15 to 28 days, luteal phase. This is over about menstrual cycle. Thank you, everyone.